Hello, hello. So this is just a nice relaxing stream where I'm going to be redrawing one of my old art pieces again because I think I have improved since then. Of course, like when you draw every day, you're going to improve. So yeah, this original one. They're kind of crunchy because of where I pulled them from, but I think this one I made when I was, I think like 12 or 13. I'm gonna say 13. And then the second one. Let me see, 'cause I posted this the second one on Instagram. That was 2019. So 2019. So yeah, we got 20. Got 2014. And we've got 2019. So we're gonna be well, I'm gonna be redrawing this little character, this cringy little rainbow fox dog. And yeah, I'm gonna draw her. Oh, it's been ages. See, I'll do the sitting position for this one as well. I'm gonna get a thicker sketch brush. Let me see. I need to make this bigger, I think. Methinks I need to make screen bigger for you folks. There we go. Does that suffice? Here, if I make if I do that. There we go. View for you. Okay. Yeah. All right. So, I'm gonna start with the sitting position. My art process has changed quite a bit too. I'm gonna get more of that proud sitting position from the original, I think. I think that's a little too much booty. Need to move that head up for more neck. No, that's the wrong brush. Yeah, I love redrawing a lot of my old art, especially when I have art block and I can't think of what to draw. And you know, it helps me see the improvements I've made. And I like seeing that I've improved because then it just kind of gives me the motivation I need to continue. I think that's a little too long of a nose. And this one particular piece of art just means a lot to me because it's like one of my oldest digital arts. Aside from like MS Paint drawings from when I was like 9 years old. And, you know, it's just, it's like a museum piece. You know? Hi, Magenta! How is it going? And yes, this is the character design that eventually became my current little goober. I have a bad habit of just starting with the head and then saving the body for last. I'm gonna give her some nice long ears. I'm gonna make this a little less spiky and a little more flowy. Little more fluffy looking. Look at her, she's so happy now. I'm so proud of this already. Who would have guessed that I'd make it this far? Not me. Not me when I was goofing around on the family computer. Drawing silly little animals. Okay, now for legs. Okay, this body is going to destroy me though. Gonna have a little bit of booty. Actually, I'm looking at the 2019 one. I think I got the body shape wrong. Do that, and that's more like a noodle, and then the booty. Maybe. I don't know. I haven't drawn an animal sitting like this in a while. Aside from like goofy cats. And goofy cats can only get you so far in life. Okay, time to make you smaller again. Okay, so pause would be down here. Yeah, this is just gonna be a nice little relaxing stream. We're just gonna chill. Shoulders a little too out there. I'll fix the legs here in a second. Let's see here. How do I adjust sitting animal legs again? I've already forgotten these things. Okay, her booty is too out, methinks. let's see here. I can fix this. It looks a little weird. Chest will come down to here. This sketch may look like nonsense, but it makes sense to me. It does, I swear. Okay, yeah, no, she might have to be standing up this time because I can't figure out the sitting position. She's standing up this year. This is what happens when I don't warm up. This is also what happens when you draw the head first and don't plan. Oh, that's the wrong brush. Draw the head first and then you don't plan anything else. Which is my worst habit of all time. See, a wiser person would probably have references, but I'm not a wise person. If I make the collar thicker, maybe I can get away with futzing this a little bit more. Better at drawing anthropomorphic animals because at least then I can futz it all I want and it'll look okay. be extra fluffy just to hide the fact that I am screwing up the anatomy. So I know we need a little bit of a bean shape for the body. Yeah. I think that back leg is a little too big. With the power of digital art, we can shrink it. Bring it on a little bit more. Now her booty too fat. There we go. I think she's shrunk in length. Let me fix her length. She needs to be long. There we go. Make her long. A long doggo. But also not quite a doggo. Okay, now it looks like her head is too small. I think that might have been my problem. Her head looks very small now. Let's make that bigger. Oh yeah, it looks a little bit better already. She had a case of tiny head. Usually I have the opposite problem where I make the head too big. She is alert and ready. Okay. All right, it's time for line art because yay, okay. Get the thickness I want. There we go, that's good. Yeah. Oh, I almost forgot a very crucial step. Yeah, it looks alright flipped. Yeah, we're good. I did it good. I'm proud of me. Yes, I manually thicken all of my lines because I I have too heavy of a hand to do the funny, fancy stuff with line pressure. No, that's much too big an eraser. I'm just, how does the, oh, the darn cat is very good. I'm having a good day today. Motivated to draw, but don't know what to draw, so here I am. Okay. Let me trim these eyebrows a little bit. I hate doing long lines so much. No, I don't want them that conical. There we go. Yeah, that's a good shape. Needs a bit of this. There we go. Yeah, that's much better. There we go. They look okay. They look a little googly. I don't know. Yeah, she looks a little googly. That's fine. I'm already so proud of myself. Best part about improving in art is going back and flexing on your younger self. I don't like that going directly to the corner. I'm gonna go a little bit higher. There we go. That definitely looks a little googly. It's okay, she's just a little quirky. A little quirked up. That one's too thick. Plop. I hate drawing ellipses so much. Why do I do this to myself? It needs to be wider at the top. Oh, wrong brush. Wish I had shortcuts for my brushes, but I do not. Because I only have a limited amount of buttons I can use as shortcuts. Looks a little too chunky. Maybe a little too thick. There we go, that's a little better. Little dingy. Burp, burp, burp. Heck yeah, detail. That I did not have back then. This part's gonna kill me. Half tempted to use the tool, the ellipses tool. I might be able to fudge it a little bit. Yeah, it looks okay. What is the dog doing? It's the question everyone is asking, but no one ever asks, how's the dog doing? Yeah, I am a crack creature. But before I was a cat, I was a fox. I just like to give animals long legs. The long legs are goofy and funny. Well, I don't need to give it scoliosis. Then I would gladly take the commission. I'm glad you enjoy this, me drawing this character from 2014 enough that. You would consider such a thing. I was just a small little bean when I made this. This is before I knew what furries were. When I first created this. I was just like, people make funny little animals on DeviantArt. I guess I'll make one too. Well, I mean, I am a small bean, but I was a smaller bean in terms of internet and art skill. Should probably zoom in when I do these, but like. I don't like zooming in. No, it's too slippery. It's too much like a thing of slippers. There we go. I'm just kind of doing the pause in a lazy way because. Sorry, I had to blow my nose. It's been a little chilly here, and it's that time of the year where everybody's getting a little stuffy. Looks a little too thin. Gonna give her a little bit more meat, just a little bit. Taper that edge a little bit more. Taper that a little more. Get my smaller brush. Outline where the little tummy pattern is. It goes under the legs. And then where the color changes are. You know, I'll change the color of the lines after so you can't really see them, but they're a good guide. Technically, this isn't even my first fursona. I had one before this, technically. But it was only ever drawn once. It was also a fox. I have a picture of it somewhere, I just don't have it accessible at the moment. Go. I'll make this one a little longer though. There we go. There is a tail. Is there anything else I'm missing? Oh yeah, I gotta. I know that that was on the inside. My bad. There we go. Find the sketch. Do a little flippy. Looks alright. Alright, and with that, we start coloring! Yippee! Actually, before I start coloring, I want to do this. Yeah, I gotta close up some lines a little bit better. Oops, didn't mean to flip. Doing one of my favorite things to do right now, which is just making the outer outline part thicker. That's gonna be a little bit pointier. And there are some, like, lines that make no sense as well. Especially if they stick through all the other line art. Like you. There's you. Alright, that should be okay now. This. Alright. Like a weird base color. That way, I forgot to deselect that inside part. Okay. Deselect. Bap, bap. Fill. Bigger. Not that much bigger. 5 3 pixels. And then we fix any of this. This a tedious process? Yes, but I don't mind doing it this way. There we go, now it's color time! Turn gray. I'm gonna start with the red. Oh, And what? It's a little too purple. I need it pinker. Yeah, like a beige. Cause I only ever use pure white for the eyes. That's another little thing I've been trying to do. Color creature. This is looking a little too gray. There. Nope. Yeah, it's a little better. But did you know you're adorable small? I am very adorable small. Small adorable. I am a little, just a little guy. Just a little guy. Sometimes I wish I was a, just a big guy. I want to be big. Want to be tall. Any little patches of white that I missed? What about you? Right, good enough. I think that's all the white. Yeah. It's a little bit of envy. I want to be tall. I want to be tall so bad. That's orange too. I'm using more of the colors from my 2019 one because they're a little less atrocious. Just a little bit. I almost forgot this part. I'll make that. I'm making all these colorful. think originally the other leg was dark blue. Got. Yeah, I think the back leg was supposed to be like a dark blue. Yeah, that looks about right. Maybe a little bit lighter. It's gotta be not that intrusive, but not that gray either. Is that a good one? No, it's still a little too dark. There, that'll do. Now we got the funny purple tail. No, they didn't have any powers or anything. They were just. She was just a goofy little critter. Yeah, dubious little creature. Purple a little cooler, a little darker. Pretty cooler. She got that bling bling. No, she wouldn't bite you. Even though me at the time that I made her originally, yeah, I would bite you. I was a biter. No, I think I'll make that more of a.
You mind if I feel?
Yeah, go for it. Scared me. Yeah, a little bit. Well, thanks for popping in. I don't think they need mobility. They're already pretty dangerous. Okay, I'm gonna do that real quick. My line's a little more crisp. Now it's time for... No, we don't give anybody ideas. The monkeys don't need wings. That and then do this. Fix the collar in a moment. Oh, I don't wanna. I don't wanna multiply. Maybe just that'll do. Yeah, that'll work. Right. Now it is time for the shading. Oh. Oh wait, no, I gotta fix the collar first. Okay. What game do you have in mind, Lucy? Color burn. Oh, yes. Okay, I might need more blue shadow. Nope. Teal. I don't know if color burn will work here because of the green. Try and multiply a rain world. Okay. shade, and then I'll fix the layers after. Here. Oh, I do got Parsec. I'm a little bit of a Parsecker. Oh, it's really blue there. I definitely have to change the color of the shadow. Well, quote-unquote shadow, I'm just slapping colors down. If I go to multiplier and make that purple instead. Maybe I should keep this one at least. There. And then we'll do some more fine shading. Well, in this case, I just kind of did standing as, like, a basic. But usually what you want to do is have at least, like, I don't know, I'm not, like, the type of person to I don't really know what I'm doing. If yes, I am just using the airbrush tool because I want to. I just kind of do what my heart tells me. Yeah, sometimes you're just so used to doing something that you just have an instinct for it. I get it. Chris, hello. Everyone say hi to Chris. He is super cool. And a little stinker. I love you too. Not a dog. I mean, close enough, honestly. I'm drawing it more dog-like. Get some of the light back in here. Right, and then fade that out a little bit. Put that on color burn instead. Oh yeah, this is my old persona from 2014. That's what this is. I know, right? We always love to see baby's first persona. It's always a treat. What if I put this? Ah, it's good there. And now time for the highlights. Okay, yeah, it's not even gonna show up on the white. Easy pink. No. Let's get some. I'll do it in blue for a nice contrasting color, and then I'll switch it after. I'll just do normal for now. When it comes to highlights, I just do whatever the heck I want. Light source, who's that? Never heard of her. I just realized I never added shading to the medallion. Whoopsies. I'll do that after. Need to be a little bit more generous with these highlights, I think. All right. Thanks for being here. This will look better once I fuss with the colors a bit. It's not going to be blue forever. Hot cartoon moms, any recommendations? No, not really. I'm not too much of a hot mom connoisseur. Not these days, anyway. Okay, you know, I was having a night last night. We don't talk about chili. I'm not even gonna provide context. Nope, nobody needs to know. I feel like something's missing. Oh yeah, I didn't shade the medallion. That's what I was missing. I forgot. Sees. Burp. Face a little bit. This glowing effect. Because I like this glowing effect. I really do. It feels like you're in the sun. Much. There we go. Very nice. Well, I think that's about it. Other than the background. Quick little background. The nice light pink. I'm gonna go with a little bit of a warmer pink. Uh-oh, I forgot to do that. There we go. Then I will... Whoops. Do that. Whoops. Wrong button. So take this there it is. Expand down a layer. I got to subtract the gaps again. Just kind of separates her from the background a bit. Gaussian blur. Side. That purple. Make that burn. Yeah, just a gradient. I think I can crop out that. Thank you. Walkies. Shadow down here. No, oh, wait, I know what to do with that. Ba-ba. I get like a little bit of a halo. Blurred a bit. It's not too intrusive. But it's still there. And I will blur it a little at the feet. Some other parts, so it looks intentional. Then I guess I just add a bunch of silly shapes. Like the original one. Bam, rose brush. Woo-boo. Nah. Maybe I'll just do lines. Do stripes. Who doesn't love a good stripey background? Alright. Actually, I'm gonna grab my little gouache brush. Draw a bunch of little hearts. No, nope, that's not a heart. I'm not liking that magenta color as much as I did. There we go. Now I just need to assign it. That's not the right color. Not the right brush. Beautiful, lovely, stunning, gorgeous. The wrong layer. So yeah, these two pictures became this one. I'd say it's an improvement. Maybe I should make my name. Yeah, this is this. Definitely. I'm gonna make my name bigger. Just pop that right over top. There we go. Well, that's kind of what I wanted to do. Thank you all for watching. I'm gonna go and eat dinner now. And, yeah. See you all next time. well, the only Switch games I really play are Pokemon and, Animal Crossing. I think I have Minecraft too, but I have that on the PC anyway, so... We could talk more later.